Childhood memories of Kez, Tiswas and Noel Sweater. But the evenings turned to Roxy Music, Matt Brolin was the discoverer and Sun Ra the tour guide. The encore, the concierge of musical taxonomy, Brian Eno. Carl Jung said children are educated by what the grown-up is, not by his talk. Well, this is my talk. I am the commentator, as Iggy Pop never said, that was the passenger. I am the gatekeeper, a responsibility to instruct an impassive public. Imagine my horror then when I was asked to choose three reasonably easy listening tunes to three reasonable adults, only to be advised that our subjects may fail to grasp the simplest of expressionist ideas. Something was amiss in this exchange, and not just in this tale, but this shot, me as I walk aimlessly through frames. Am I somehow creating a reality that exists merely in the restraints of its context? Or was this an alternative reality where the complexity of its meaning gave credence for its claim to somehow be the reality? We don't have time to address that now. Like the process of fast-moving traffic, it was time to move on with this segment. I've chosen Pull Revolving Doors from Radiohead's Amnesiac album. It took 10 years for some critics to accept it made its mark, but how would a member of the public make sense of it all?
Music. Jesus, what a load of shite. That was absolutely brutal. Pulk, Pull, Revolving Doors by Radiohead. 4 minutes of the same electronic shite. Brutal is all I can say. I feel travel sick after listening to that. Oh, you can't even understand what the guy is saying, or girl, or whatever it is. Radiohead, I don't know. How long have they been going? How are they still going? That's the main question. They are dumb.
My second choice is an obscurity from duo Kevin Doria and Joe DiNardo, also known as Growing. 3 minutes of serene drifting giving away to another 3 minutes of godly industrial howls, as if the cogs of heaven churned away to invent another colour, the colour of sound. But how would this process sound for the cogs of the untouched?
Well, it's a bit shite really. Didn't really know what to make of it. Like, it was... it's not something that I've ever watched, I've ever listened to before, so I couldn't compare it with anything. But my overwhelming conclusion was that it was basically a pile of wank. I suppose the word you're going to use is abstract. It's very unusual. It's like a bunch of random sounds and mixed up, played backwards. There's no sense to it. It's completely nonsensical. It's not music. It's turd. It's just a bunch of sounds, no meaning to it. I don't like it, I don't dislike it. I wouldn't listen to it again. It was rubbish. The thought, when I tried to kind of sum it up in my head, what it, the feeling, the imagery that it produced in my mind, it was kind of like an elephant farting through an electric harp. That about concludes the steaming pile of dog shit.
And finally, Delia Derbyshire, the sculptress of sound. Wielding away in the BBC studios, she created the Doctor Who theme tune without a single instrument or synth. Here Come the Fleas is taken from her band White Storm's seminal Electric Storm album. There is surely nothing taxing about this one.
Why'd you do the things that most people frown at? You haven't washed yourself a week.
Go back to sleep.
Yeah, I think to be honest, she was on some really bad acid. It was like a throw up between Monty Python meets the Magic Roundabout. On some really heavy drugs that I wouldn't recommend to anybody ever, ever. Don't do that shit. It's wrong. Oh man, that it was just crazy. I think she might have been a Buck Rogers fan at some point as well, but then started sniffing some really bad glue. Avoid. It was utter garbage. Innovative, it means that it should be going somewhere that had no direction at all. It was all random. It was the 70s would be so proud.
So there we have it. To the learned, three songs that define what it is to be human, where boundaries are like bookends of the universe. But to the initiated mass, it was nothing more than alien distress codes, random sequences of noise, not yet, and perhaps not ever, to be translated. Join me next time when I'll be uncovering Dutch elm dancing in Marbella.